In the previous video, we looked at the workings of BJT and JFET. So going with that flow, today we'll discuss the comparison between these two types of transistors. Both of these transistors are important components in electronics, but they differ in terms of structure, operation, and applications. Let's go through the main differences one by one. First is structure. Starting with the structure, BJT and JFET are designed differently, which influences their performance and applications. BJT has three terminals, emitter, base, and collector. The base is the controlling terminal, and the current flowing into the base controls the large current flowing between the emitter and the collector. This makes BJT current-driven devices. JFET also has three terminals, source, gate, and drain. The gate is reverse biased and controls the current flowing between the source and drain. This reverse bias operation ensures that the gate ideally does not draw current, making JFETs voltage control devices. Thus, the main difference is that BJT is current driven while JFET is voltage driven. Second is working principle. The working principle of BJT and JFET are fundamentally different. BJT is current control device, where a small base current controls a large current flowing from the collector to the emitter. This amplification mechanism makes BJTs ideal for analog signal amplification. JFET is a voltage control device, where the gate voltage creates an electric field that controls the current flowing between the source and drain. This high impedance control mechanism makes JFET suitable for high impedance applications. Next is types. In terms of types, BJT and JFET each have main two types. BJT is available in two types, NPN and PNP. In NPN BJTs, current flows from collector to the emitter, while in PNP BJTs, the flow is reversed. JFET comes in two types, N-channel and P-channel. N-channel JFETs are more commonly used because it has electrons, which are the charge carriers in N-channel, have higher mobility than holes, which are the charge carriers in P-channel. Next is input impedance. The input impedance of BJT and JFET differs significantly. BJT has low input impedance because it requires a continuous base current to operate. This can affect the input signal, making BJTs less suitable for high impedance applications. On the other hand, JFET has very high input impedance. Since the gate is reverse biased and ideally does not draw current, it does not load the input signal, making it highly suitable for sensitive circuits and high impedance circuits. Next is power consumption. The power consumption of these two devices is also different. BJT generally consumes more power because it requires a continuous current at the base to function. JFET is more power efficient because it is a voltage control device and does not require continuous current at the gate. This makes JFETs ideal for low power applications. Next is switching speed. When it comes to switching speed, BJT and JFET behave differently. BJT has moderate switching speed, which is sufficient for most analog application and audio applications, but may not be ideal for high speed operations. JFET has faster switching speed compared to BJTs, making it suitable for high speed analog circuits and digital circuits. Next is cost. Considering cost, BJT and JFET vary based on their construction complexity. BJT is cheaper because of its simpler construction and widespread use in electronics industries. JFET is slightly more expensive due to its more complex construction and voltage control nature. Next is applications. Finally, let's look at the applications of BJT and JFETs. BJT is commonly used in amplifiers, signal processing application, and switching applications. Its ability to amplify current makes it ideal for audio amplifiers, radio frequency amplifiers, and digital circuits. JFET is used in high impedance application like audio amplifiers, for sensor amplifiers and precision circuits. Its high input impedance makes it suitable for sensor amplifiers and phono preamplifiers.